It will be happening from 2 to 5, so stay with us, stick with us. We're going to have programming, artist talks. Some of our poets are going to read their actual full pieces. So a lot of what you see here from wall 1 to wall 5, there's actually poetry, excerpts of their full poems inside of every single wall.
Came down one night, at night. I don't know who it was, but they pretty much had a flashlight fixing some of the places. A flashlight!
As a town, as a community, as a people, as a country, as a world, we've got everything it takes. But it will take everything we got.
What's going up, y'all? St. Jose Fuertes, Joseph Thomas, by the real name, by the government. And yeah, I feel really good about being a part of this project. I didn't think it was going to be as big as it is and like as impactful as it is, as people, you know, in the city cross by and see it and like have a real like response to it. It feels really good to be a part of this, and I'm glad that I was chosen.
Well, my name's Gina. I'm an Orlando-based artist and designer, and I do mostly abstract paintings and also I freehand letter. So my contribution to this particular mural is doing these lettering sections. So we have Booker T. Washington, we have Ida, we have Malcolm right here, the poet Nikki Barnes. She came out with this poem, and I'm basically just taking each line of her poem and putting them in the clouds. So the idea is for like the youth to like kind of like look up at the clouds and, you know, direct like Spike, mean it like Malcolm, write like Ida.
Rise up like Maria Stewart, Mary Ann Shad Carey, Mary Church Terrell, calling them. Teach like W.E.B. Film like Henry Louis Gates Jr. Direct like Spike. Preach it like Dorothy Heights. Lead like Dorothy Cotton, like Andrew Young, like Barbara Lee, like Shirley Chisholm. Teach like Septima Clark. March like Fannie Lou Hamer and Amelia Boynton and Selma. Free each other like Harriet, like Sojourner. Rise like Coretta.
That's beautiful. It's amazing. These people are so talented, man, for real. And I'm glad, because at one time it was nothing but vulgar language and just peeling paint, and that's amazing. I commend them. I mean, I really do. That's beautiful. Whoever did this, whoever thought about this, you know what I'm saying? I really commend them on that.
So I'm Little Lily Lettering. I've been lettering for about 3 years now, and I mainly stay as a lettering artist and calligrapher. I do some random canvas paintings and things like that. And outside from that, I really love the fact that I randomly applied for this position, I guess. It was very interesting. I actually applied to be a muralist, but then turns out looks like they needed someone to actually put the letters up on the wall. So it worked out great. And yeah, this is my first time doing something this large scale, and I'm really impressed with how everyone's coming together and helping each other out and working with each other. And it's pretty awesome being around other like-minded individuals. I find that either if you're an artist or a letterer, you tend to be more by yourself and do things all on your own and try to, you know, especially being an entrepreneur and doing all of that stuff, it's like overwhelming. But everyone here gets it, and everyone here is great, and everyone's really friendly and super nice, and I'm really loving this experience. I'm loving getting to know Eatonville and the town and its history.
Hi, I'm True Poet. Those are actually my words, and this was one of the coolest projects I was ever a part of. It was cool to collab with a bunch of different people, artists, muralists, calligraphy artists. It was just so dope to just work together and make a big project that everyone can enjoy. I'm not trying to say my life is perfect, because a crystal figurine glued back together can never be perfect, but baby, I'm standing. I'm shining. I'm opening up my eyes and finding more things in my life that are okay. I'm happy. I'm writing love poems so sappy. I'm lapping up all the fine wine. I'm dining at the table of life and I'm grubbing. See, before I was Cinderella scrubbing, but now I'm bumping shoulders with boxy ticket holders like the clock is never gonna strike 12. Like sweet chocolate doesn't melt, but that's okay because it tastes good. just like black educated men can still come out of the hood once they have found their balance, where they came from, and what happens to surround them. Life's trying to drown them in a puddle of blood from not knowing love, but they surpass that. And I've learned that the silver linings are not hiding. Like many, I did not know that they were found floating around the heaviest clouds of glow, celestial, angelic, severely magnetic, holding so much kinetic energy, just waiting to blow. But it just goes to show that it's always going to rain. Just like you and I are always gonna feel pain, just like nothing ever stays quite the same. I'm sure a thunderstorm will definitely change the terrain, but the soil probably just needed water for the plants to sprout. Don't doubt the power of struggle. Don't expect your bubble not to pop. Stop worrying about your future and live in the now. What's around us? The street parks that ground us, dreams that hound us, beats that meet the sound of our ancestors. The ones that knew hope and faith on a first name basis, getting discriminated by bigoted races, but they still found their silver linings. Never once had to go skydiving, so you just gotta look up at a cloudy sky. Find the light, peering through the darkness is okay. The sun can still rise on the next day. You can still rise. You just gotta find the silver lining.
I am royalty. Nappy hair coil, BDB Rasta lock sewn down to perfection. Baby hair laid like butter, skin as deep as the Nile, as smooth as shea, black as hematite, or as yellow as a sunflower. I am royalty. A queen, to say the least, a goddess if I'm being modest. I was made in God's reflection, so I gotta be the hottest. The sun speaks to me because he loves my melanated skin. My glow within is reflected in my walk. Does my haughtiness offend you in the way that I talk? Well, I will not be silent. You will hear me when I come, and you will know when I leave. And if my presence isn't missed, then my absence is a necessity. You don't have to like me, but you will respect me. This world cannot hold me. I am a warrior, the epitome of unstoppable. Queen of the jungle, lioness of her tribe. They will write about me in history books. My power they will describe as boundless. I am not your property, so approach me properly like I pass life through my womb. I am changing, I am changing. I am free, I'm free from my cocoon.
So my name is Sati, and my piece is based on, the inspiration comes from just having the freedom to just express and do better and just come out winning out of whatever circumstance. So that's basically what it's all about. I'm originally from Florida, but I'm all over the place now, LA, New York, everything's inspiration. So the sounds and their textures are really what inspire my words. So anything having to do with sound, it could be, you know, can of spray paint, it could be anything. It just brings words to my mind. So as far as the concept for the piece, Joe did most of the work when it comes to, you know, but he pretty much just brought my concept to life.
I just wanted to do something eye-catching, something fun for the youth, and that's about it. It just reminds me of my childhood, playing basketball and maybe painting on walls, usually with permission. Just reminds me, this is just my life. This is all I've ever done. So.
It's beautiful when people come into all different types of neighborhoods just to beautify it, as opposed to just tearing it down to make something new. I like it when art and culture can come into an area that's been around forever, just so that it can now get more trendy and more modern. And then it also brings art with the people that's been here forever, so they can see something new, because they've been around here forever. I know a lot of people from Eatonville, and I work around the corner from here, and they're used to what they see, and it's nice to see some color and difference in the neighborhood. I love it.
To sketch this in my sketchbook, I did a little sketch, and I showed everybody the sketch, and I was like, oh, this is your first mural, and to put that on the wall, if you get to do that, then wow, man, the sky's the limit. So after this, I plan to just keep on doing more things like this, because this is a great honor to me to do this for Eatonville. It means a lot to me to see the neighbors come out and appreciate it, and to meet everybody here, it means a lot, man. It really means a lot. I can't.
We are brothers and sisters, daughters and sons of a generation who wanted to give up on love years ago, but we do our best to uncover it. We are like a constellation, beautifully illuminated by our imperfections, but we wear our indifferences like armor. Because we fear what we'll see if we allow that 1 second of individuality to understand emotions and display vulnerability. We are brothers and sisters who inhale criticism and exhale cynicism because the men before us do not acknowledge a cruel world, so we only embrace it, drape ourselves in abject misery, try to stitch and mend the problems of our history. We are brothers and sisters, a mass of degenerates in despair, who crave a sweet, loving feeling for the lack of love that we knew because no one told us we would be born in such a place. I wonder when unhappiness became so impossible to replace. But at some point in between the energy, the passion, the optimism, and the pride, we are here together with the fulfillment of desire to do something better for the next generation.
I hope that when you look up into the sky, you see yourself. Because you sparkle as bright as the sun in the middle of July. I hope the stars will remind you to always be yourself, to always be the light, to always stand apart. The skies can be a lonely place for the sun, but it never apologizes or hides. It doesn't care about the opinions of others or fitting in. Each morning, it will always do what it was made to do. And it is my hope that this will be your daily reminder to always do what you were made to do. Shine.
Like you said, the first day that I came in, it was like everyone was family. I met my people, I met the same creative drive that I have surrounding me in a room, and that's a beautiful thing. You know, I can create so much on my own, but when you have other people working with you, you can elevate it to a level that you could have never seen from just your perspective. So I appreciate every one of the artists that helped me and inspired me. So thank you for everyone for coming out, and it was amazing. Also collaborating with poets and adding that other element to it that just brought it to even more than I could have imagined in my original painting. And I hope that the kids enjoy it.
Okay, so I'm Simone, LaCharger's Tots Assistant Director. Our facility actually has been a part of the town of Eatonville for the last 25 years. I think what the artists are doing with our children is amazing. The way we picked them were the kids who had both parents attend our childcare actually as children. So his mom and dad attended the daycare center, and so did the girl up there. So that's how we chose our students. And then this is the first time they've ever, I guess, did a tribute for Zora in this big way, and we do appreciate it. It's right next to the center, and then to give our kids a sense of the history of the town of Eatonville.
All right, my name is G. Limas. I am originally from Honduras, grew up in Miami. When I was in high school, I got inspired by the autobiography of Alex Haley, the autobiography of Malcolm X. And that was probably the first book that I ever read from front cover, like from the front to the back. It was such an inspirational piece that I wanted to research the rest of the story, you know, and I found out all these different characters within that frame, including around that time was jazz musicians, you know, poets. I mean, there was just a cultivation of all these different people that were trying to uplift the black community during that time. And Zora Neale Hurston was one of them. And I learned that Zora Neale Hurston had traveled with Malcolm X to Africa to learn about African culture and how it related to the Middle Passage and how you can uplift the mind of the Negro during that time. So they created this thing, it was Renaissance all together, and that was the new wave, the new way of looking at us. And it really inspired me to the point that, you know, I was always moved by her books. And out of nowhere, you know, the opportunity came and where I can actually paint her portrait. One thing led to the next, and here it is.